Stalin's morbid paranoia grew. Nobody at any level of life in the country, regardless of whether they were in the party or not, was safe. From his desk, the great terror was controlled and conducted. Secret police orders gave every region an arbitrary quota for the purges. Category 1 meant death. Category 2 meant the prison camps. But at times, Stalin grew impatient when he scribbled, "Give a supplementary quota of 6,000 people in the first category to Krasnodar." He was signing the death warrant for an extra 6,000 on top of the previous target. The purges struck many of the earliest enthusiasts for communism. Mikhail Minlin, in Category 2, was arrested and interrogated by the secret police in Moscow.
When the interrogation began, I was asked to sign lies about myself and good comrades from my region. They handed me a list of 47 people. They wanted to get me to sign a statement. I wouldn't. They kept me standing for 5 days. Day and night. My legs were so swollen.
At the height of the purges, ordinary people were required to take part in mass demonstrations against enemies of the people. Yet some, who'd been most devoted to Stalin, were still blind to what was going on. Ella Shishtya, the young electrical engineer, couldn't believe what her husband, a party official, told her.
He understood. He knew what I didn't know. When he said, "You can't imagine it, Stalin is shooting all the present members of the Politburo," and he counted them off one by one.
Зиновьев, Каменев, Бухарин, Рыков,
I couldn't bear it. We were having lunch. I picked up a knife and threw it at him. Thank goodness I missed him, but that was what was happening at the time. Stalin was shooting them all.
She broke with her first husband over this slur. Later, he was purged and killed. She fell in love with and married a second man who still shared her unquestioning adoration for Stalin, but he too was purged. Then, as the wife of an enemy of the people, Ella Shishtya was herself arrested and sentenced to prison in Siberia. She was sent with a party of other women crammed into goods wagons. With nothing but salt fish to eat, she developed a desperate thirst.
I remember when there was a hard frost. Inside the wooden cattle truck, I used to lick the ice off the metal screws and bolts, fearing only that my tongue would stick. That's how we traveled, for about a month.
Though their husbands had been killed before they left Moscow, the women were convinced they were in the railway wagon just behind them. As the train went east, they sang a song to their men, hoping they'd hear.
Это мы, ваши жены, подруги, это мы нашу песню поем из Москвы по сибирской дороге вместе с вами этапом идем. Прочитали в бутырках нам приговор, дали каждой жене 8 лет, и, вручивши конвою пакеты, повезли нас по 100 человек. Было тяжко в холодной теплушке, ели только мы рыбный кондёр. У конвоя выпрашивали свечку, не теряя былой свой задор.
Mass shipments of prisoners continued for years. They filled thousands of camps in the remotest and most inhospitable parts of the Soviet Union. Prisoners became an essential part of the workforce, slave labor for the new mines and railways, being forced through regardless.
First, I worked on the Bam Railway. Then in Kolyma. The important thing was not to die of hunger.
Баланду тебе давали. Баланда это суп без всякой, ну там.
They gave you balanda, a soup with just a few fish bones and some oats floating around. We drank from metal bowls. They gave us a ladle of balanda and a lump of bread.
Вот так вот выпивали его и пайку хлеба. Еле-еле нас заставлял холод работать еще, потому что если
we could hardly work for the cold. If we didn't move or work, we would have frozen.
И когда человек хочет, ну, оправиться в забое, так он должен.
When someone wanted to relieve themselves, they had to take their mittens off. By the time they undid their trousers, their hands were frozen. As soon as they pulled it out, it froze. Many people had their parts amputated.
Никаких там уколов, никаких.
There were no injections, anything to reduce pain. They didn't even have proper scalpels.
Даже не было операционных скальпелей. У меня, например, на лагпункте на
джунгле. When I was in the camp, they asked me to hold out my frostbitten foot. And with pliers, they just took chunks out. That was the treatment, the operation.
И все. Вот и все лечение, вся операция. И тот, кто первую зиму.
It was considered that if you survived the first winter, you'd get through your sentence. Most people didn't survive.
Большинство не выдерживало.
Stalin's henchmen tried to justify what was happening. Applauding the message was the loyal construction worker Татьяна Фёдорова.
А то, что какие-то вот такие политические интриги, игры, которые были, если будут, к сожалению.
The fact is that unfortunately you always have political intrigues, machinations of this kind.
Не заслонило движение вперёд никак.
It was a very hard time, but it didn't derail the movement forward in any way. Because the country was growing at great speed. We're talking about a country of many millions. The whole population worked, sang songs. It doesn't mean that everything was extinguished, everything was lost.